Welcome to the part two of the Crazy Pages collaboration. These are the pages are prepared in the past video. Click on the cards over here somewhere on the top of the video for the iCard where I will show you the first video that I made for this project. Hey guys, Martha here. These Crazy Pages, because everyone is going to be making one of a kind for the rest of the team. For this particular video, I'm going to be using green, this kind of aqua turquoise blue, bronze, iridescent bronze, orange, and some metallic aquamarine, which is pretty much like a turquoise type of color. I'm going to be applying colors in dry brush technique, but this particular set of pages have more texture, have an extra flap, or have some other things in here that I'm going to highlight with the metallic. At least that's the basic idea. If you want to see how I made the other one, make sure that you see it at the end or in the iCard, because this is going to be different. And I'm going to speed up the process, but basically it is going to be dry brush technique and metallics with a little twist. Actually, I forgot to mention that for this set, I'm going to use first a watery color and to give it a base of a different color variation from the other set of pages I made. So I'm going to start with my aqua, kind of watery, but I'm not going to put it evenly everywhere. It's just going to go in certain areas. This layer is ready, it's all dried. And now I'm going to be playing with the green and this other blue. I've been thinking of how to use this glitter, but sometimes you gather materials and then you don't use them. From the other video, I had it handy. I love the color and it's glitter. I mean, it's awesome. But I am never sure if I'm going to use everything I put on the table. I still have hopes to put in somewhere. I just don't know where at this point. But I'm keeping it nearby. And for now, I'm going to be adding these colors and my bronze. But that's going to be for the end, because it's also... I'm going to use it first kind of dry and then a little bit wet, and it will drip different colors, but I need all the other stuff to be ready for the drips. And then this is going to be the front, but I'm going to add a layer of medium in the back to make them a little more sturdy and more leathery feeling. At the end, so thick that it feels just wonderful to touch it, like old paper, some, I don't know, really, really good texture. I have the green and it is dry. So I'm going to add the orange in some areas. I will go finally with the bronze. I am dying to use it in this part over here, but I'm still playing. I think I'm going to add a detail of the glitter down here, just some little punchinella marks in the bottom corner. And same with the orange, I'm just going to add a little stain here or there. Just mostly to use it, because I think it is a good punch of color. Maybe a little bit over here, and then I will go with the bronze on top. I'm just kind of still not sure where I'm going, but I want those colors in there. All right, the orange is down. It is still wet, but if I'm going to be working on the opposite corner, I can do a little of the glitter that I want to do. I guess somewhere over here. It depends on where, I mean, the patchy paper is not in the same place in every page. So in some parts it is like on the bottom part, or some others is over here on the top. So I will just go and do my punchinella. And I just need to find my sponge. I want to rinse it, and I have no idea where it is, so I will be right back. Okay, I have my sponge, and I have a little bit of the glitter, and it's going to look really cute. However, it's not even going through the template evenly. It's like it's gonna do whatever it wants, and that's fine with me. I just need to, I guess, put it in the parts that I see that are a little more flat. Like the green is totally flat, it's not shiny at all, but it's still going to be really, really fun to see in there. Whoops. Well, this over here went a lot, so I'm going to put it in here. Hey, what do you think? I don't want to put one on top of the other that are still not dry. Oh, this one already has some. Maybe I can put a little bit more. That was very little. There we go. Here comes the fun part. Well, actually, all of it has been fun, right? I have been having a blast painting this, but this is going to be a special touch if I can open the bottle. And the way I will do it, well, first I'm going to get a clean brush because this one still has, no, I guess it's fine. Okay, it's clean now. I'm going to apply, actually I'm going to put a little bit here on my little palette, there. I'm going to put some, and it is kind of a thick paint. I'm going to let it rest a little bit. Just like this, it looks awesome. However, I'll come back with a little bit of water. And it separates the metallic part with the other colors in the paint. Let me see if I can bring the camera closer. Hold on a second. Okay, look, it's separating this over here. If I start picking up with a napkin, number one, I'm going to be jiggling the camera, so sorry about that. But if I start picking up, see this gorgeous thing? Whoops. It leaves beautiful golden green shadows. I'm not sure if the camera can pick this up, but anyway, it is a beautiful effect. See? It looks aged right away with some green hues. So, okay, I'm going to be repeating that same process. Oops. On all these other pages. And I'm going to fast forward a little bit of this same step, and then the rest I'm just going to do off camera because it's just repetitive, but you get the idea. Here are all the pages drying, or actually almost totally dried. I am very happy with the results. If you like more acrylic techniques, art journaling, and mixed media videos, this is your channel. Don't forget to click on the subscription button and also click on the bell so you get notifications every time I upload a video. And remember to keep your paintbrush wet.